Sacrifice is extremely glorified in our Vedic culture. How did you raise your children? By sacrificing for them. How did you become a graduate, postgraduate? By sacrificing your time. So sacrifice is the secret of progressing in virtue. Everybody who is doing sacrifice is getting purified. Some believe tremendously in offering their wealth as sacrifice. The founder of the Methodist Church, John Wesley, had said, "Earn as much as you can and give as much as you can. There is no harm in earning if you do it as a means of giving." Earlier, before I came to Maharaji, I was in Bombay. I was managing a temple there. And Arvind Mafatlal was connected with that temple. Arvind Mafatlal, some of you may be knowing, he was of the Mafatlal group, one of the big industrial houses in India. So there I came to know of this astonishing soul. He was managing a huge empire. The entire Mafatlal Industries. And yet he was full of devotion. Every day after waking up, he would go to his puja room. And nobody could reach him there. Absolutely nobody. He did not care whether the company is going up or down or anything. Those 2 hours are for God. He was responsible for getting the Ramayana on TV, right? So he had such love for Ram that if you say Ram before him, his body used to start shaking. He was the disciple of a big guru of Gujarat called Ranchodji Maharaj. He used to do charity all over India without telling anybody, quietly. There was no name, nothing. He was running 10,000 eye operations in Chitrakoot. No publicity of any kind. Even today you go to Chitrakoot, you won't find his name anywhere. So, what was his belief? When he was a college student, he ran away from home and went to his guru and said, "I want to take sannyas." Guruji, seeing his background, he's coming from a big industrial house, said, no, you don't take sannyas, you do your worldly duty. So while doing his worldly duty, he just saw that this is a way of bhakti. Let me earn all I can and let me give all I can. That is the motivation behind Warren Buffett. He still lives in a 4-bedroom house. You know, sometimes as I travel around, I have been to our Indians. Once there was an Indian I went to. Oof! 20 bedrooms? Husband and wife only. And they've got a 20-bedroom house. And they are so scared. I don't know what they are scared of, but in every room now they've installed Radha Krishna as an insurance policy. So look at Warren Buffett. After earning so much, he's still living in his 4 or 5-bedroom house. That earning is his way of bhakti. Earn all you can and give all you can. From the point of view of God, he doesn't see how much you have given. He sees what percentage have you given? What austerity have you undertaken? When the BHU was being made in Kashi, Banaras Hindu University, so Madan Mohan Malviya. Now this was in the time of Britishers, so it was the first Hindu university being made. He went around doing fundraising. And one rickshaw puller, he gave 12 annas, that is 3/4 of a rupee. So in the board of donors, his name came. Now somebody say he only gave 12 annas. Madan Mohan Malviya said he gave his 3 days income. He used to earn 25 paise every day. So he gave 12 annas. That means he gave his 3 full days income. That is why I put him out there. So God sees your bhav. So sacrifice is what purifies. There is the story in the Mahabharata. When Yudhishthir Maharaj was doing the Rajasuya Yajna, now he used to feed 10,000 Brahmins every day in a golden vessel, and they were to take the vessel back after that. While the Yajna was going on, one squirrel came. One side of its back was golden and the other was blank. The squirrel was repeatedly jumping on the other side. After trying 4-5 times, the squirrel said, "Dhik Yajnam, fie upon this sacrifice," and it was about to leave. Yudhishthir said, "Why? The squirrel is commenting on my Yajna?" Bhimsen lifted up his gada, "I'll smash it into the ground." Lord Krishna said, "Ask the squirrel why it is saying dhik yajnam, fie on this yajna." So they asked. The squirrel related its story. It seems that a few years ago it used to live outside the city of Hastinapur. There was a poor Brahmin family's hut. There are different kinds of Brahmins described in the Vedas. Some are those that when the market where the grain is bought and sold, the grain that falls on the ground, they can pick it and cook it. Some are those they can go and beg from houses and cook it. That is their vrat. And there are some, when it is cut in the field, whatever falls on the ground and it has not been picked, they'll take that and cook it. So this was that kind of Brahmin family. For a few years there was a famine in that land. And because of that, there was complete shortage at home. This Brahmin family, the Brahmin, the Brahmani, the son and the daughter-in-law, they had not eaten for a few days. Finally, they managed to get some food and the Brahmani cooked the meal for all of them. The son was newly married, the new daughter-in-law at home. They all sat to eat. In the meantime, one atithi, guest, arrived. He said, "Sir, I have come from very far. I am extremely hungry. Can you please give me something?" The Brahmin called his wife and said, "Look, he is the guest. Our dharma is to sacrifice for him. You give him my share. I will not eat." The Brahmani gave that share to him. He ate, he thanked them, and he departed. Now 3 people's portion was remaining. The 3 of them sat to eat and a second traveler arrived. He said, "I have come all the way from so far. Is there anything at all you can give me?" The Brahmani said, "Let me feed my share to him." They fed her share to this traveler. He ate his meal, he thanked them, and he went from there. Now 2 portions were remaining. The son and daughter-in-law, both of them were young, strong, energetic. The parents said, "Please sit and eat." The 2 of them were about to eat when a 3rd traveler arrived. The son said, "If my parents can sacrifice, then why can I not sacrifice?" He said, "Please give my portion to this traveler." He was also satisfied and sent from there. Now only one portion was remaining. So the daughter-in-law was to sit and eat, and a fourth traveler arrived. The daughter-in-law said, "Look, I have to follow the tradition of the elders. You are going hungry to feed the guest. Please give my share to this guest." Atithi Devo Bhava. So when she said that and they fed the Brahman, the squirrel said, "I was watching the scene from one corner of the hut. At the sacrifice of that family, the devatas, they showered flowers from the celestial abodes." The squirrel says, "I was so happy, thrilled at what I saw. I leapt up, and when I fell down, the side on which I fell, that turned into gold. So one of my sides was gold and the other was not. I thought whenever I get a chance, I'll make the other side also gold." And then I heard the great Yudhishthir Maharaj is doing the yajna, Rajasuya yajna. "Well, let me go and try it out." She said, "I repeatedly jumped, but nothing happened. That is why I said, dhik yajnam." Shri Krishna said, "Bhimsen, answer to the squirrel. You had lifted the gada, now what?" Bhimsen was without an answer. The squirrel departed. Yudhishthir said, "Maharaj, what deficiency remained in our yajna?" Shri Krishna said, "Yajna depends not on what you give, but on what is your capacity to give. You got it from here and there, from various people, and you gave it. And that poor family had nothing, from that they gave it. Your yajna cannot compare with theirs." So yajna means the sense that Shri Krishna is taking it. One is fire sacrifice, but here Shri Krishna is broadening the definition and saying yajna means sacrifice.